Very good morning, cadets. We are moving to the next topic, very sensitive topic, the topic of religion, communalism and politics. Why I called it a sensitive topic? Because if the religion is expressed in a positive way, then religion definitely helps for the overall development of a personality. At the same time, if religion is misinterpreted or wrongly explained, then the same religious dogmas or the same religious practices may prove hindrance to the human society or human civilization. That's why we should be very careful while dealing the issue of religious sentiments. We should make sure that the religious sentiments of ours should not disturb the religious sentiments of others in the society. That's why the topic is carefully chosen and explained to you how religion and politics takes a ugly turn in several countries. Let us move to the topic in the context of India. Religious difference is fairly widespread in the world today. So, we studied about the Northern Ireland. Catholics and Protestants both belongs to Christianity. Even though both belongs to Christianity, there was a clash among them. So, religious issue is not only related to India. Religious issue is spread throughout the world. That's why we should be very carefully handle the issue. Point number two. In India, we have many religious groups when compared to the various countries in the world. India is considered as one of the mother country for several religions in the world, because Hinduism is one of the religion which is widely spread in India. Apart from Hinduism, India is also land which we can find the people belongs to the Christianity, Islam, Jains, Buddhists, Sikh, Parsi. Probably India is one among few countries which give shelter to the people belongs to the several religious groups. Point number three, the religious difference is often expressed in the fields of politics than in any other difference like gender and caste. Most of the time, gender and caste may not play a tricky role in a politics. Gender, if male or female, we studied in a Indian political scenario, less number of female contest for election, gender difference. But male or female contesting for election, by keeping this particular point, it is very difficult to differentiate the society or bifurcate the society. But religion can really divide the society. That's why we should be very careful. That is what we say. When the religion is expressed in politics, it may lead to disintegration or division of society. That's why we should be very careful, because gender and caste got a less influence than the religion. Okay. The religious groups are mentioned here. India is considered as motherland for several religions. We have Hinduism, Sikhism, Jainism, Buddhism, Islam and Christianity. Try to understand, India is such a wonderful country, because probably other than India, very few countries may be there in the world which gives shelter for all these religious groups. So India is a motherland for all the above major religions. A beautiful image of India, map of India. Now question is for you, can you identify certain religious symbols given here? This is a religious symbol, this is a religious symbol. So this symbol is very common, this symbol is also very common. So my question for you people, try to understand the which religion this symbol is belongs. Okay, let us move to the how this religion is expressed in India since independence. Mahatma Gandhiji, father of our nation, Mahatma Gandhiji never separated religion from politics. Try to understand what I am explaining. Mahatma Gandhiji said that religion cannot be separated, can never be separated from politics. But Gandhiji, when Gandhiji spoke about religion, that religion doesn't mean Hinduism, Christianity, Islam, Sikhism, Buddhism. No, it's not that religion what Gandhiji says. According to Gandhiji, every religion, there is a policy of morality, ethics, philosophy. Every religion teach moral values, ethical values, philosophical values, or we popularly call as dharma. Dharma is the path of truth. If you may be heard the famous sloka of yada yada hi dharmasya glanirbhavatu bharati. What happens here? Lord Krishna says that don't worry about what happens in front of you, because it's all controlled by me. But Krishna promised Arjuna that whenever there is a little problem or truth, then definitely I will take an avatar and solve the problem. That is what we speak about religion. So Gandhiji's view of religion is not Hinduism, Christianity or Islam. He say that every religion got ethical value. So Gandhiji used to say that religion can never be separated from politics, but religion doesn't mean particular religion like Hinduism or Christianity. He believed that politics must be guided by moral values and ethical values drawn from the religion. So he says that what is important for politicians? Politicians should definitely follow the moral values and ethical values. Imagine what a wonderful idea of Gandhiji. Gandhiji explained that there should be ethics, there should be morality, there should be philosophy. So if there is a morality, ethics and philosophy, definitely no leader, I am repeating, no leader will involve in corruption, no leader will involve in nepotism, no leader will involve in supporting the unfair things in Indian politics. So that is what Gandhiji's idea about religion. Continuing further, whenever there is a problem in the religion, the Human Rights Commission always argued that whenever there is a religious clash or communal violence, most of the time who are the people who are affected by the communal violence is minority community. Let it be any minority community, let it be in India, let it be in Pakistan and other countries. In Pakistan, Hindus are minorities. So as a result, in Pakistan, whenever there is a religious clash, Hindus are suffering. In India, other minorities, including Christians, Muslims and all, most of the time, they suffer whenever there is a religious clash. So Human Rights Commission observed that the communal rights generally prove dangerous to the minority community. Now coming to point number 5. Don't think that every religion respects women in a same way. There are many instances where in Indian society there were several problems in all the religions. Let it be Hinduism, let it be Christianity, let it be Islam. Take for example, in Hinduism, in the previous years, equal right was denied for female child in the ancestral property. But now it is become a law that equal right should be given to women. Same way, you see, in the recently Prime Minister Modi's government passed a law in which triple talaq is banned. So in Islam, the practice of triple talaq, now it is banned by the government of India. So like that, if you searched for these kind of examples, you will get lot of examples where it is very clearly said that wherever there is a discrimination, let it be any religion, the women's movement, definitely the lady who fought for triple talaq, she is from Islam only, she fought several years to get justice by the court and all those things. So definitely that is what we say, women's movement argued for the come out from the religious discrimination against the women. All the above instances involve a relationship between religion and politics. The government should treat all religions equally. So what the government's role? Government should treat all religions equally. That's very, very important topic. To try to understand, what we studied is how religion is expressed in the politics. We studied Gandhiji's view on religion. Gandhiji said that religion and politics should not be separated, but Gandhiji's view of religion is a religion, not a particular religion. He said that all religion got ethical values, moral values, so leaders should inculcate all those ethical and moral values. Okay, let us move to the next topic, the topic of communalism. The topic of communalism, if we understand, India is one such country which suffered certain severe communal problems since independence. Immediately after independence, we witnessed one of the tragic moment, incident of partition of a country into India and Pakistan on religious groups or religious lines. This is the first example of communal violence in India. After that, we witnessed the communal violence of the Babri Masjid, demolition of Babri Masjid, and resulted in communal clash in Mumbai and other places throughout India. After that, we also witnessed the communal clash of Godhra violence. So in India, we unfortunately witnessed several communal riots. So what do you mean by communalism? Point number one, communalism is the worst expression of religious difference. Means if you say your religion is different from others, and if you go on proving that your religion is far, far better and singular, then definitely it is a worst expression of religious difference. Communalism is nothing but, point number two, clash between religious groups on religious grounds called communalism. If the religious groups clash on the religious grounds, it is called communalism. Our country witnessed several incidents of communal riots since independence. So few images you can see here, the images of communal violence. This is the image of communal violence immediately after independence. You can see the trains are overflowed because people were forcefully sent from Pakistan, few were forcefully sent from India, because in Pakistan Hindus were sent to India, and from India Muslims were sent to Pakistan. So partition of country definitely led to a tragic moment of communal violence. This is the second incident of communal violence which we witnessed in Mumbai. The Mumbai communal riot was one of the worst riot, because this riot is the post Babri Masjid demolition. When Babri Masjid was demolished in Ayodhya, that resulted in communal violence in throughout India, but it took very ugly turn in Mumbai. Several people had died, property was damaged, people start hating other religious groups. Another most tragic in the recent days, not that, is Godhra violence. These are the few pics of Godhra violence. whenever this kind of communal violence take place, definitely people start hating each other, people start killing without reason. That is not good for the country, because one of the major issue is that we start killing our own people, our own brothers and sisters, and very important, we damage public property. You can see here train is burnt, the vehicles are burnt. So communal violence definitely lead to a very ugly turn. So that's what we should avoid communal violence. My homework for you, please make a note about three communal violence. Search topics is same, Godhra violence, then Ayodhya Babri Masjid case, as well as the partition of India. Please make a note that when it has happened, which states are suffered because of this violence. At least make a note of 10 to 20 sentences, so that intention is very clear, so that you will understand what is the effect of communalism or Indian society. Let us continue the same topic, the point number 4. Communal politics is based on idea of that religion is principle of social community. So what is communal politics? Communal politics is nothing but religion is the basis for social community. That means if people say that our religion is the basis for this politics, then definitely it leads to communalism. What is the point number 5? Extreme form of communalism leads to the belief that people belongs to the different religion cannot live equal citizens within one nation. If he starts thinking that only my religion can sustain in this country and other religion cannot live in this country, that is considered as the worst form of expressing communalism. That definitely lead to communal violence, loss of life, loss of public property, and all other damages to the country. So we studied about meaning of communalism. Let us move chapter in a little steady manner, a slow manner, because try to understand the meaning of communalism, how communalism is expressed in India, and try to make a note of those three communal violence which India faced. First, communal violence in India. Try to make a note of that, so that you understand that how communalism is very badly affected our country in the past. At least in the future, we can avoid certain communal violence in India based on the ugly turn taken by the political parties. I'll meet you in the next class. Till then, take care.